Are you planning to buy a home in Calgary? If so, this is the entire buyer process explained in a short and simple guide that you're not going to want to miss. Hey everyone, it's Ryan Gillard here with Real Broker, your favorite Calgary realtor. Now, buying a home in Calgary is not something that the typical person does on a routine basis, so to go through the process can be kind of daunting and scary. So in this week's video, I'm going to break the process down into a simple step-by-step guide from start to finish. Let's get right into it. Okay, first things first. So step number one is to secure a mortgage pre-approval. Before you do anything, you're going to want to have a good idea of what you qualify for before you even start to view homes or submit offers. And we can do this by securing a mortgage pre-approval. A pre-approval is the process where the bank or lender takes in all the buyer's information, like their income, their credit score, how much debts they have. And they use that information to give the buyer a good rough idea of how much they can qualify for. It's also good to start here because it'll give the buyer a good sense of what their monthly payment will be and how much the interest rates are. It's important to note that a mortgage pre-approval is just an estimate, it's not set in stone. To get a firm approval, the bank will look at your financial information as well as the subject property itself. So they're probably gonna do like an appraisal, they wanna know the insurance, inspection, they'll look at your financial records again, so income, bank statements, tax info. There's a long laundry list of items the lender's going to ask from you. To take you from a pre-approval to a firm approval. Step number two is to pick the area or the areas that you're interested in. And the more that you can narrow it down, the better. You know, in Calgary, I get this quite often where a buyer will send me some properties and we'll have one up here in the Northwest and we'll have one way down here in the Southeast. It just tells me they're not totally familiar with the areas yet. And so what I would do is I would drive the areas, walk around them, just kind of scout them out. I'd check out the schools, shopping, transit, the amenities, you know, how long does it take for you to drive to work? Is the C train close by? Just all the things that you might be interested in. I would just go down to those areas and check them out and see if they fit what you're looking for. Now, if you don't do this, this also happens to me quite often, is you might find a property that you like and we go and visit it. And then you love the property, but you just hate the area and you wasted your time. So it's best to do that first, just to get a good sense of the neighborhood to see if it kind of ticks all the boxes that you're looking for. And then you can move on to the next step. Step number three is to filter the search results. And you can do this by making a list of what is mandatory. Like it's a must for you to have 3 bedrooms upstairs. If it doesn't have that, that property is not an option. So all of the musts, the things that you'd like to have but are not necessary, and the things that you can live without. Now keep in mind, during this process, you might have to make some concessions and come down in value, or you might have to come up in value as well to get what you're looking for. So try to keep an open mind during this process. So here is a rough guideline of the things that you should be looking for when starting out with the process. So the age of the home, the size of the home, how many bedrooms, how many bathrooms, is a garage important? Does the basement have to be developed? You know, things that you don't like if there's busy roads that you won't live on a busy road. You won't live in front of a school, stuff like that. If you're looking at a condo, no ground floors or no below grade units. It doesn't have to be a corner unit if you're in a condo. Basically, be mindful of what you like and dislike so you can help narrow the search down, and that'll definitely help the buying process along. Now, there are thousands of properties for sale in Calgary, and I would strive to get this down to your top 3 to 5 properties. That's the kind of detail that we should have here, and I definitely think that will help you along with the buying process. Step number four is to find a realtor to work with that can help you along the buying process and can also negotiate strongly on your behalf. Now, in Alberta, in general, the seller pays the commissions for both the listing agent and the buyer's agent, so there's no upfront cost to the buyer to hire a realtor, and they can also take advantage of the realtor's experience at the same time. So there are no real disadvantages for the buyer to pick out a realtor to work with. Step number five is to start viewing properties. Now, buying a home is largely a process of elimination, so get out there and start viewing homes and, you know, tick off what you like and what you don't like and start eliminating some of those options. Now, during the viewing process, I'm always mindful to ask the buyer what they like, what they don't like, so I can, again, filter the results and make it as manageable as possible. In an ideal world, a perfect situation, we've narrowed it down to the top 3 to 5 properties, we view them all at once, and we write an offer on the best one. It really can be that simple if everything is done correctly. Step number six is submitting an offer. So the buyer is viewing properties, they finally found one that they like, and they're ready to submit an offer now. So at this point, I'll meet with the buyer and I'll go through each section of the purchase contract, and I'll let the buyer know my thoughts on what has to be done for them to both secure the property and also to protect themselves contractually. I'll also go through some recent comparable sales with the buyer to establish an appropriate offer price. Now in Calgary, our market goes through cycles. We've had buyer's markets, flat markets. Right now we're in a pretty hardcore seller's market, and our offer has to kind of reflect what's happening in the current market. And so I'll go through those the conditions of the current market with the buyer to establish, you know, a good offer that we can submit. And also to note, most offers in Calgary, they usually have a financing condition, a home inspection condition, condo documents, and occasionally there's a condition for the sale of the buyer's home. Those are the four typical conditions that you see in most offers in Calgary. There are others, but those are the four main ones that are very common. Step number seven is the negotiation process. So I have the buyer's offer, I submit that to the seller's agent, and the listing agent, you know, brings that to his client, who is the seller. The seller has the option to accept our offer the way that it is, they can outright decline it, or more often than not, they actually counter our offer. So at the moment in Calgary, it is a bit of a red hot seller's market. So we're seeing a lot of competing offers. We're seeing unconditional offers over list. And we're seeing sellers just pick an offer that's the best and just accept it the way it is. But that's not normal though. Usually there is some back and forth between the buyer and seller. And you know, things up for negotiation are, you know, price, possession, the deposit amount, some of the inclusions in the property. Even the condition timeline length can be up for negotiation, or various terms like professional cleaning. Like, so everything is up for negotiation. And so it's typically between the listing agent and the buyer's agent. It's not the buyer and seller negotiating, you know, face to face, or they're on the phone. It's usually the two agents who are talking on behalf of their clients. And try to keep a cool head during the process. I've seen many deals fall apart over really minor issues. And so don't lose the forest for the trees. I think that's the expression. Just try to keep a cool head during the negotiation process. Don't take it personal, and just try to be as cooperative as you can, within reason. Step number eight is the conditional period. So we've submitted an offer and the seller has accepted it. And more often than not, it's accepted pending financing or pending a home inspection are the two main conditions that you see in Calgary. And like I mentioned earlier, a mortgage pre-approval is just an estimate. It's not set in stone. So what we have to do is go from a pre-approval to a firm approval. And how we do that is we send the MLS information form and the purchase contract to the buyer's lender. Again, the firm approval is on a specific property at a specific price, and then the lender will analyze everything. So they have the MLS information form, so they have all of the information regarding the home, and now they have the purchase contract, all the terms and the price and the possession. And the lender will see if it all works in their eyes. So again, they might ask for an appraisal of the home just to make sure they're lending an appropriate amount for the home in question. They might ask for additional income documentation. They might check your credit score again. They'll ask for like bank statements. They'll ask for all sorts of different things. So it's a long laundry list of items that they'll need to go from a pre-approval to a firm approval. For the home inspection, it's a bit of an easier process compared to the financing condition. It costs about $400 to $600 for most home inspectors in Calgary, and it takes about 2 to 3 hours for the inspector to come in there and do a full evaluation of the property. Now, most buyers will wait till they have a firm approval before spending the money on a home inspection, which I understand, but there can be some complications with that. If you wait for the very last minute to do the home inspection, there might be issues that you want to have addressed, and if you're up against the clock, it could be difficult sometimes. And there's no guarantee that the seller doesn't have a backup offer that might actually be better. And so you could put yourself in a difficult situation by delaying for too long to address the home inspection items. If you're purchasing a condo, there's typically going to be a condo documents condition. You're buying into a corporation, so you're gonna wanna understand how the corporation works, what you can do, what you can't do. So the seller rounds up all the documents and provides them to the buyer. The buyer has a choice. They can either analyze the documents on their own, or they can hire a specialist, which I would probably do. The documents can be kind of heavy. There's all sorts of different things to look at. There's like the bylaws, there's monthly minutes, annual general meeting minutes, there's the reserve fund study, there's the financials. So it can be kind of complicated. So I would probably recommend hiring a condo review company to do this. And to note, so this conditional period, it typically lasts somewhere between, I would say, 5 to 10 business days. I would say on average, it's usually around 10 business days to complete all of these different items. Step number 9 is the waiver. So we're at the conditional phase, the financing is approved, everything is good with the home inspection, and the buyer wishes to proceed. At this point, I will send the buyer the waiver. It's just a simple little form that says, I, the buyer, am satisfied with the following conditions. Usually it has the financing and the home inspection condition in there, and the buyer signs off on it, and I send it to the seller. As soon as the seller has this waiver, the property is sold. So this is when the sold sticker will go up on the sold sign. If the buyer backs out at this phase, they will lose their deposit. There's no turning back once the waiver is signed. So you've essentially bought the property. Now, the opposite can also happen. If you're in the conditional phase and for some reason the financing falls through, you're not approved, or there's just too many issues with the home inspection and you don't want to proceed, there's something called a non-waiver. So just the opposite of the waiver, just says, I, the buyer, am not moving forward because of these conditions. You sign off on it, it goes to the seller, and then you get your deposit back because you backed out during the pending period. So it's fair to both parties, the contract. If you back out after all conditions are removed, you lose your deposit. But if you back out during the conditional phase, you get your deposit back. Now, regarding the non-waiver, most transactions stay together. I would say about 10% of the time the transaction will fall apart. Usually it's because of financing. And I would say usually it's because the buyer didn't get a pre-approval done beforehand, or they didn't hire a good mortgage broker and that person didn't do their due diligence. Oftentimes the buyer goes to the bank and they just glance over their income and say, oh, you're approved for this amount, but they don't check their credit or their debts. It's very aggravating, but it does happen in the industry. And usually it comes from not hiring a good mortgage person. So we're getting close to the end here. So we're on step number 10, which is to find a lawyer. So once the waiver is signed, essentially the property is sold at this point, and both buyer and seller have to pick out their own lawyer. And the listing brokerage will send both lawyers all the paperwork that's been completed so far on behalf of the buyer and the seller. Now, the lawyer has an important role in the process, and it's to help facilitate the legal change in ownership. So they deal with land titles, they help clear the title, they help adjusting property taxes and condo fees, they help get you set up on the tax plan. They also deal with the buyer's lender to get the money to send to the seller for possession day. So they have a very important role. Now, I do find that a lot of for sale vendor types mistakenly believe that the lawyer is there to sell the property and do everything. They have an important role, but it's more so to facilitate the change in ownership than it is to sell the property. Now, for a buyer to hire a lawyer, for the longest time it was around $1,200. Some were lower, some were higher, but that was a good rule of thumb. But just the last couple of years with the increases in the cost of living, lawyers have had to raise their fees as well. And I'm finding it might be closer to $1,500 now, up to say $2,000. So the costs have gone up, but it is important to hire a good lawyer. Step number 11 is planning the move. Now, this one is fairly self-explanatory. It's cleaning your current place, packing your current place, hiring a mover to take all your stuff from the old place to the new place. You're gonna want to organize mail forwarding, changing your address. But probably the biggest one here is to have in the contract a pre-possession walkthrough, so you can quickly zip into the property one day before you're supposed to take ownership, just to verify that the home is still in the current state it was when you wrote the offer. So no fires, no floods, all the inclusions are there that were promised in the contract. And sometimes there's professional cleaning before you move into it, so you can verify that. Just stuff along those lines. And number 12 is the actual possession day. So this is obviously the most exciting step along the way for a buyer. This is when title transfers, the seller gets the money and keys are releasable and you've taken ownership of the property. And that's pretty much it. So you've taken ownership of the property and it really can be that simple. So that's my quick guide to the buying process in Calgary, fully explained. Again, my name is Ryan Gillard. I'm a local realtor here in Calgary with Real Broker. If you are planning to make a move and to buy a property within Calgary, I would love to help you out. So feel free to reach out to me. You can call, text, email, or comment. I will get it, and I'll get back to you. Thanks again for watching, and have a great day.